I told you, I'm a master's student. I'm not a professor or a PhD or something else. And I'm a fifth year at computer science here at NTNU. And as Per said, I'm going to talk about the Android online patterns. A little bit of twist, of course. Just in case if someone here haven't seen the pattern, have someone here used the pattern or is still using the pattern?
Yeah. Shame on you.
I'm still using it.
I turned it off yesterday.
Yeah. As Per said, you can, you have to at least connect 4 dots, and you cannot visit the same dot twice. And of course, that makes restrictions of how many possible patterns you're able to make. So, what I'm kind of interested in is the theoretical password space versus the, I call it the practical, because people don't make patterns that look like this. When I walk to school and I want to change some music on my phone, I want to check Facebook, I don't want to make a strong, some kind of pattern like this. I want to access my phone easy because it takes too long of time to, like, have too long of connect too many dots. I think it's kind of similar to what Janice said. People don't want to, like, pick this. The people want to pick the easiest way out. So, when looking at passwords, you can, if you have a service, you can kind of predict that people will choose words that connected to the service or connected to you as a person. But what about this stuff? How do we predict this stuff? Do anyone have any suggestions? How can we predict people's choice in Android unlock patterns? Yeah.
Letters.
Letters? By how? Letters. How can we predict people's passwords or patterns? Yeah.
From what he said with letters, they might, because it's 9 digits similar to a phone.
Yeah.
A little cell phone had certain letters with each number, so you could try spelling something with that.
Yeah, so this one will be 9. The 1, 2, 3, 4. But yeah.
Or maybe they could try to draw the quadrant that looks like something.
Yeah. Draw something like a square or anything else.
C or maybe A.
You need to get people to actually do it, see what you do.
Yeah, of course you have to, like, somehow know what people are doing. Yeah.
Something that's symmetrical or something that makes sense of password that you actually remember.
Yeah, something that you remember, some kind of symmetrical, yeah. When you look at something, a password is always something more than just letters, words, and even patterns. How can we be able to, like, use who you are to predict what pattern you make? If you ask what part of you could reveal your pattern? This is kind of funny, when I present, like, the size of your hand, Per is laughing at me. You can't ask people what their size of your hand is. Do you know how you could combine this with something else, like a mobile phone, to predict the pattern?
Screen size.
Of course. The screen size. If you combine the screen size and the size of your hand, how you're able to predict the pattern. I think Per was, like, giving you a hint when he started the introduction. How do people start a pattern? on the upper left. Okay, if you have a small thumb and a really big hand, won't it be kind of a hassle to like reach some part of the screen?
Why just only one hand? You can use it.
Yeah, of course, if you are with walking in the street and holding your mobile phone and using your other hand. But how do people interact with a mobile phone? Using both hands or using one hand?
One
hand.
Especially if you're driving.
Yeah, of course, if you're driving. What about this? 40, I think it was 44% starting in the upper left corner. But most people are right-handed. But what if you're left-handed? Would you start in the other corner? Can someone predict what this is? I think someone was kind of ahead of me when I went before starting the presentation. What about your background? Your reading and writing orientation, isn't that kind of how you... And the reading and writing orientation, like if you're starting like Arabic languages where you read from right to left, there are studies that there were people that were presented like 9 images, and people with different reading and writing orientation was asked to remember the pictures. People that had like reading from left to right, they were able to like scan from left to the right and then remember the pictures from the start. And the difference was with the people that was, for instance, Arabic. They started scanning the picture from the right to the left. But that may be impact, or maybe able give us a hint of how to predict people's patterns. So this kind of research is and aim to tell me who you are, and I will tell you your walk pattern. Yeah. So this research is kind of in the start. I'm going to collect a lot of patterns and different kind of demographic information about the users, and then analyze it and maybe find a correlation between who you are and what pattern you're making. So at this point, I'm still sitting and writing. I have to do a little kind of report. But the fun starts in the next semester when I'm collating the data and hopefully I will find some answer is some of the properties that are helping us to predict patterns. Yeah.